Oh yeah, YouTube. Welcome to my channel. I'll be doing a quick unboxing of my brand new George Foreman Power Grill. Now this model number is GRP101CTG. This George Foreman grill has 100 square inches of cooking space, cooking area, whatever. And basically it's saying that it can serve five. So I guess you could put like five burgers on there at once. Okay. But enough of all of that. The reason why I have this is my George Foreman. I had a huge family size one before. I bought it 12 years ago. It died 2 weeks ago. And it broke my heart. But that's okay, because I love this new one that I got. And the reason why I chose this model is A, it has an on and off switch. B, it has removable grill plates. So I could take the plates off and throw them in the dishwasher or throw them in my sink and wash them, which is awesome. And three, it matches my appliances. So let's go ahead and get this thing open. Alright guys, we got the box open, so let's start taking out what's in there. Obviously this is the manual. Alright, this is the drip tray and little spatula thingy, I guess. It's a deeper dip tray than I had before. Awesome. Alright, this thing's a little heavy, so... Pull it out. Okay. I'm assuming this may be the plates on top here. Open that up. Yeah. Not a huge cooking area, but enough. This is enough. I'm going to be cooking bacon primarily on this. That's what I do on this thingy. Get that up. Yep. And like I said, these are detachable. So I think going forward, they should make all the new grills with detachable plates. I don't understand. With an on and off switch, I don't get it. I don't see why they don't have an on and off switch. That's the weirdest thing to me. All right, well, this is the grill. Let's zoom in on it. I think it looks nice. All right, so this is what it looks like, guys. Without the plates in, obviously. Now I'm going to show you how to put the plates on. So this is the top plate. Now I kind of have to flap them out like this. See? And I have to hold them like this and then attach it, I believe. Yep, then it comes on. So I don't know, I guess this side goes like that. Just clamp them on. There you have it. I do have one little concern. It's not really bad. Some of you might be a deal breaker because a lot of people whine a lot. The bottom piece is a little flimsy. I could easily pull it up. You know what I'm saying? So, see? Yeah, both of them are down. I could easily just pull it off. So, that shouldn't be a problem, because why would, you know, you're putting food on there. It should be no problem. The bottom part, it is no problem. So I just wanted to let you know that does fit loosely, but it's no problem. Before I put it in my cooking area, I also want to show you the on and off switch. Where is it? I don't know if you could see it. Let me try and zoom in. Yeah, there it is. See? Right there. On and off. And that, to me, is completely awesome. Alright. Alright, I'm going to show you quickly the cooking area that I'm going to put it in. Right in that corner between my coffee maker and the sink. Okay, so I just put it in the area. We'll get a little closer. It does sit a little high, but I'm going to fiddle around with it right now and see. So that's what it looks like right there. Alright, here's a closer look at it. So what happens when I turn it on. See? I'm so excited. Now I don't have to plug it out anymore. Thank you, Jesus. Alright, I'm going to open it up. That's what it looks like. Boom. Boom. So that's about it, guys. That's my George Foreman grill. Of course, I'm going to do two videos on it. I'm going to cook some bacon on it, of course, probably in the morning. I'm going to cook some burgers on it as well. There's the drip tray. But also, I want to show you. Yeah, I forgot to show you. This has a little stand in the back, like a little lifter. I think you can. I could go like that, or I can go like this. I guess like this makes it slope down, which definitely I want, because I want the grease to slope down and get the heck out of my food. That is the whole point of me getting this. But some of you might not matter. It might not matter. I guess you have it the other way. You can make it level if you were doing waffles or something like that. Because I'm assuming you can take these grates and interchange them. I didn't get any additional grates, but I know that they do have a waffle grate. A waffle plate that you could put there as well. I might try that and do a review on it. But anyway, that's my video, man. Hit like if you like it. Remember to hit subscribe to my channel because, you know, I'll be doing some other appliances and cooking some other crap that I get from the supermarket. But if anything, thanks for just looking at my video. Anyway, I'm out.